I am going to show you how to create seamless patterns using PatternedAI app here in Canva. It is so much fun. There's a variety of ways that you can create patterns. So let's jump right in. I'm super excited to show you all that you can create with this. So here we are. And if you go into your Canva dashboard and you click on apps, type up here PatternedAI, and this is the app that we're going to use today, PatternedAI. Now I've used, as you can see, I have used several of these pattern apps, and PatternedAI by far is my favorite just because you can use lots of different elements to create something that is unique. Okay, so that's what we're going to pick today. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on that. And here is the dashboard for PatternedAI. And so we have a variety of different ways in which you can create your own unique pattern for your brand. So we're going to go ahead and start with the generate one. So here is your prompt. So you have to try to get as descriptive as possible with the image that you want to create. So this is the prompt that I'm going to use. So pink background with a different color donuts with sprinkles, cute and colorful. Okay. Now the next one that you can pick is your style. So you can click on see all, and then you have all of the different styles that are available. So you can try with, you know, again, which one goes with your brand. I'm going to go ahead and do line art, and that's it. I want it to generate two images. It's good. You can generate more, you can generate less. Just know that you have a limited number of credits for it. So if you are on the Canva free plan, you have 20 credits, I believe it gives you to generate images. And if you have the pro, you have more. So it's going to go ahead and generate those two images for you, and perfect. There it is. That was quick too, right? So here is my image that I created. Perfect. Exactly what I gave it, right? Cute and colorful. So those are my two images. So it gave me, this is my first image, and then this was my second. So of course this is AI. So remember, it's not going to be perfect because this is, I have no idea what that is. It's not a donut. Right. So we'll go ahead and go with this one here. That is perfect. So now some options that I have here is you can zoom in and zoom out for the image. So I'm going to show you what it does. If I use it just like this, right, I'm going to add it to the image here, and this is my background. Okay. So now if I go here on the next page, I want to zoom out. It's just going to create more donuts on the screen. So let's check this out. See, there you go. And then here we'll zoom all the way in so we can have less donuts as a background. And there we go. Okay. So you have one image, and they could give you three different background effects based on how you zoom in or zoom out. See how quick and easy that was? But of course, you have to create a prompt, right? And just as if you were to use an AI like ChatGPT or Gemini, right? It's the quality of the prompt that you put in is going to be the quality of the image that you are going to get. Okay, so be as descriptive as possible to get the image that works for you. Okay, and then once it clicks on here, so it works just like an image, right? It creates an image for you, so you can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, you can, you know, lower the transparency if you want just a little bit here, and that gives it a totally different effect. If you would like to use this as a background image, then lowering the opacity would be perfect because you want the text to be the what shines through, right? Not the background image. So lowering the opacity would work perfect if you want to use this as a background image. So I really like that you can edit just like you would an image. Okay. All right. So that is the generate one. So that was quick and easy. So let's go ahead and use the create. So here with the create, it creates different patterns for you, and they could use your own images, or you can use images from Canva. Now to save some time, I added some elements here from Canva. And so here in the create, what you'll do is that you will select your image, and it will automatically add it to the box here where you're going to create your seamless pattern. Okay, so you're going to work within this box right here. So you have several options here from the patterns, right? So you have three different options here. So let's say for this donut here, if I only wanted a pattern with the donut, so let's go ahead and change the background here. Let's add a pink background here. All right, that looks good to me. And then what you'll do here, I'm going to create this pattern here. It's kind of a little bit offset here. And so here it's what it's going to look like, right? So I'm going to zoom in, or actually, yeah, zoom in. And then the spacing, you can make the spacing however you want the spacing to be. Right, I'm gonna add a page, and let's go ahead and add that background. And there we go. So we can create that pattern there. And then this pattern is very similar, right? But it's right, it's more in line versus these are offset, right? So that's the pattern. That's the difference between these two here. Okay. So let me go back to this page here, because I want to add multiple items. So this is how you will do it. I'm going to go ahead and make this donut a little bit smaller, and then I'm going to add the cupcakes and the cake pop, right? So now here you can go ahead and move these around, and you can go ahead and duplicate. So let's go ahead and duplicate the cake pop. I want to add one there, and then I want another donut right over here, right? And then you can move these around. And if you click here, you have the more options. You can also make the elements to the move them forward. You can send them to the back, right? So if you want to add them, these are already layered on top of each other, but let's say you wanted this one on forward, you can go ahead and do that. Oop, did it work? Bring forward. There we go. Okay, so those elements are still there, just like they do up here with some images here. So let's go ahead and move this around the way I would want to make a seamless pattern with all of this delicious dessert. Right? So let's see, what do we want? So then you can just move these around like this. And again, remember, we can come here to see the pattern. Right? So let me zoom in. Let's bring the spacing a little bit closer together. And I think I might want this to come down just a little bit. Let's go like this. All right, let's add it here. And there we go. There you have a seamless pattern. So you can use it as a background image. You can use it for maybe products or something for our print on demand folks out there, right? So pretty easy. Now, what you may have noticed, the sign that came up with the image was saved. If we go up to our upload, you will see that the image is automatically saved to the uploads folder. So it didn't automatically save these here. So all you have to do is just download them and save them, and then re-upload them so that you can use them as graphics here in Canva. Now, the next part is your gallery. So now with the gallery, this is for patterns that are already pre-made for you. So let's go ahead and click on one of these, and it works exactly the same of what we've just been creating, right? So you can come in here and see if something that matches your brand or whatever you might be thinking. So I'm gonna go ahead and let's stay with the donut theater again and donuts. And then, oh, I thought that was my own design. I'm like, wait a minute. No, but it looks pretty similar. Oh, that's crazy. All right, so here, so there's one donut design, right? So if it already goes with my brand, why reinvent the wheel? It's already there. And again, it works exactly the same. Zoom in, zoom out, add it to the background. Boom. The repeating background is already done. That's crazy that it already had a donut one already there. So that is the pattern AI. If you still want to manually create your own repeating seamless pattern, check out this video here where I show you how to do just that right here in Canva.